Oh, internet! Don't get excited. In fact, prepare to be disappointed. Prepare to be disappointed. Alright, I'm gonna try to embarrass myself a little bit here, but, that's actually not gonna be the worst part. Should probably actually, I don't know, eat breakfast, warm up, do anything besides try to play Oye Como Va first thing you wake up. Yeah, so this thing. Now, hold on. Let me, allow me to justify this purchase. As you see, what I saw in the picture was this. This mouthpiece with this wear mark hanging way out here on a 1984 horn. So I thought probably a 10 millimeter shank mouthpiece hanging way out. It's gotta be too long. I bet this different looking receiver looks different this time. I bet that receiver is for an actual trumpet shank mouthpiece, right? That is a completely reasonable thing to believe, right? And that is the sound of soul-crushing disappointment. No, what this guy is this is, get a nice good look at it. See all these wonderful chatter marks? This is a wonderful copy lathed 1.5C. And they've produced what mathematically comes out as a 10.15 millimeter shank by chopping the end off of it. Get a nice good look at that horrible backbore. Not that any of these Russian mouthpieces ever have nice backbores, but the walls on this guy, they're a little bit thick, ain't they? Yeah, somebody got the bright idea that what they really needed to do was make one of these, take the big old chonker mouthpiece from the concert trumpets, i.e. this guy. Yes, these things are set up to use the same mouthpiece, sort of. I mean, we're 2 millimeter gap off. That's, I guess we can accept that, because, in case you hadn't figured this out yet, I don't think, anybody actually cared nearly as much about shank sizes and gaps as I do on these, Soviet instruments. So, just real quick, I'll take my, 1.5C. We'll shove it in here and we'll see what it sounds like. Really small backbore for this, but okay.
Okay,
Sounds really thin, but it works. So yeah, this was not quite what I was looking forward to. And of course, the receiver is like installed poorly anyways, so with the stock mouthpiece, I get about 4 millimeter gap, and with mine, I get 6. Neither one of those is where I want it. I might get this fixed, because I mean, I got the other parts horn with a receiver that could work. The problem is, I have already asked someone about this. So I've got a place in Kansas City, Austin Custom Brass, that they do, you know, trumpet stuff. And I'm like, hey, would you guys be willing to do this? And they're like, don't know. And their tech guy isn't in on Saturdays. So I would have to go up there on a Saturday, drop my horns off, leave them there, probably come back the next Saturday when they say, nah, not doing it. So here we are. What do you think? And no, there is no, not even a lipping in tune partial false whatever. There's no pedal tone, man. It ain't happening. So if we ignore how bad I am, and that my gap is like a millimeter larger than I would like it, which is, you know, not ideal, but it's okay. It's not terrible. See, I told you they can make kind of good instruments. I mean, the quality is not there. I don't know if this will show up. Yeah, see, that's not straight. The valve block is not straight. The angles on this are all kinds of janky. This thing looks really weird to like play it. But you know what? You got a place here for your thumb, so it's not impossible to hold. Pretty tough to do one-handed though. This. I don't recommend that because you'll run your base of your thumb into the rotors because there's nothing there for you to like put any kind of pressure on. So one-handing, not a great idea. And on this side, you get this, and I guess you can put your thumb here on the button block thingy. I don't know what you want to call that. A post of some sort. It's not really a support post, but I guess you can put your thumb there and set your two fingers in these gaps and maybe set your pinky underneath. And that kind of gives you an okay grip. So, not ergonomically fantastic. And of course, like all the Kiev instruments, pretty stiff on the spring tension. And of course, the first valve out of the three, if you look at this, so air coming in this way. So, good, bad. Not ideal. First valve is the only one that turns the wrong direction. Fantastic. plus very stiff springs. Good luck trilling on this thing. It's not very easy. Yeah, once again, I don't know if I can recommend this. I mean, I know why this design exists. It's because it's easier to do this than make pistons. And, you know, obviously, if you recall the first time I tried to buy one of these, yeah, I don't have a whole lot of confidence in guys who can mess this up making a piston trumpet. So definitely don't buy a piston trumpet from Russia or any former Soviet state, or at least not one that was manufactured in the Soviet era. How about that? Don't get one of those. You probably don't want one of these either. Unless you're just like me and you like gimmicks. You know, what kind of receiver are you going to get? Who knows? Probably not the right one. Do you know how to fix it? I guess you could try that. If you know how to do that kind of stuff, you got the tools to desolder this and monkey it around, put a different part on here, you can go right ahead. Or you know, you could be a nerd like me and you just happen to have a 10¼ millimeter shank trumpet mouthpiece. Yeah, playing a, well, it's not really a Perronet trumpet now, is it? Playing a jazz trumpet with this big old mouthpiece and an A3 back bore, not ideal. This is, I mean, it doesn't sound bad, but, you know. I guess it works. Doesn't feel good though. Just, I don't know. Really, rotors on a trumpet. This, I don't know. There's something mentally about this that's wrong. I mean, so much of brass playing is mental anyways, right? And when I'm playing rotors, I don't feel like I should be playing trumpet voluntary or, you know, any of these kind of militaristic or regal sounding pieces. This doesn't work. This should be like a fluid kind of thing, right? So why can't somebody just make the opposite of this? Like, okay, don't put rotors on a jazz trumpet, put pistons on a concert trumpet. Wouldn't that be nice? I mean, they used to do that. I'd kind of prefer to have one that's not like 100 years old, though. Anyway, here's a nice little side-by-side. See that drastically different in size? Or the bells? The bells different? I mean, tapers a little different. There we go, yeah. I regret everything.